to go alone for international borders.
Look, I'm not saying that we're going to open the international borders for just one state. What I'm saying is that we're happy to have a broader conversation with them of what their plans are around quarantine, around opening up internationally. That's the key point. We've set those targets in National Cabinet at 70 and 80%. We want to stick to them.
Okay. Everyone wants normality, as we were talking about before, but New South Wales is bracing for a really hard October in terms of case numbers and probably a rising death toll and a stretched hospital system. Have Australians been properly warned about what opening up and living with COVID is going to mean?
Well, it's certainly a conversation that we're having right now, Tracy, with the Australian people. And that is about the fact that you can't eliminate the virus, you need to live with it. And that means continuing to have health restrictions in place, which can be short of those stringent lockdowns that we currently see. That's really important. That is really important. And so we are focused on ensuring our health system is prepared for the cases that it may have to deal with. That's ensuring that we have the right workforce in place, but that's also ensuring that Australians are conditioned.